Good evening friends. Today we are here to discuss about the Excel sheet programming, how to perform in Excel. Firstly, we are going to discuss with the basic part. The basic part start with the structure of Excel book. Excel book basically is having different parts like this. Book 1, Excel is written. It is called title bar. So if anybody asks you what is the name of title bar, whatsoever program we are giving, that will be written in title bar only. And it is your quick access toolbar. By default, in quick access toolbar, four options will be there. A user can arrange as per frequently use the system. And below the title bar, this part is called tabs. If you click anywhere, option will open accordingly. So this is a part of tabs. In tabs, for each tab, different options are there. This particular option is called ribbon. So we have covered, it is title bar, it is quick access toolbar, it is tab section, and it is your ribbon section. And ribbon section is designed to reduce the screen structure. Basically, each function cannot be performed on same screen. That's why they have divided in different parts as per requirement. And now in ribbon, see now, this part is a combination of related to saving the data, cut, copy, paste operation. So full part is divided in group. So group is clipboard, this group is font, this group is alignment, this group is number. So each group is having proper name, styles is also there, cell is also there, editing is also there. Now see other part. Now group name will be changed. Here group name is table, illustration, add-ins, chart, speaking. If anybody asks you what is the group, group is a collection of more than 2-3 operations that are clubbed together in a one part, that is called a group. So we have covered title bar, quick access toolbar, tabs, this is your ribbon part. In ribbons, this is called group, and this is your name box. Which column or which row on currently we are? Suppose we are here, column name is A1. If we are here, column name is D4. It is for giving the name. And this is called your formula bar, where you can directly put up any value. If anything I am typing here, it will directly go to the formula section. See now. Now, and this is your combination of rows and columns. If anybody want to ask how many rows in an Excel sheet are, so I am giving you today one command here, that is most important command. Just I'll press Ctrl plus down arrow key, directly it will move to the last line of your Excel sheet. And the, now see the last line. Last line is 1048576. If anybody asks you how many rows in one Excel sheet, so total rows are 1,48,576. Now I'll come back on the first row. For that I'll press Ctrl plus up arrow key. I'll come to the first row. Now if anybody asks you what is the name of last column, so I'll press Ctrl plus right arrow key. It will directly move to the last column name, and last column name is X, F and D. And X, F, D, if anybody asks you how many total columns in one Excel sheet, total columns in one Excel sheet are 16,384, and total rows in one Excel sheet are 1,48,576. This is the basic structure, and this is your Excel area. If anybody asks you, define spreadsheet. What is the answer of spreadsheet? Spreadsheet is a collection of rows and columns arranged together in a sequence, and spreadsheet is designed to perform mathematical operation or to managing the record or to managing the Excel sheet. So it is the basic structure of your spreadsheet. Now we are going to start with the functioning of spreadsheet. One more thing, if anybody asks you how many sheets we can insert in one spreadsheet, we can insert maximum 255 Excel sheet in one workbook. You can search 255 worksheets. So this is the basic structure. Now we are going to start with some shortcut key part also. See now, in file section, which are the options? Options are info, save as, like this only. If anybody asks you what is backstage, backstage view is that view that is not directly visible, that is hidden backside of your screen. And backstage view can be presented by clicking on which option? File option. When you click on file option, it will present you the information related to your how to protect your workbook, inspect workbook, manage workbook. Generally it will not be visible, but when you press on info file option, it will show you the backstage view. And excluding file option, all are your tabs that will display on same screen. Now one more thing, how to minimize the ribbon. If you I want to extend the screen size, for that I can reduce this part. For minimizing, what I'll do, I'll right click on which part, I'll right click on tab option and I'll click here minimize. So that part will be minimized now. So this is for minimizing. Now come to the next part. Now we are making basic Excel sheet related to the student records. Firstly, I'm giving the name, student, father name. Third, I'm taking physics marks. Next, I'm taking chemistry marks. Next subject, I'm taking bio marks. Next subject, I'm taking English. And next subject, I am taking maths. I want to prepare the sheet. So next column, I am taking total marks. Next percentage column. And last column, I am taking position or grade. Now see how it will be prepared. First question, you will ask the question now. It is not coming on full column. What is the solution? Go to the top corner and press double click here. It will arrange by default. Which column is not arranged? You can arrange by default by clicking double click on that column part. Now I'm starting to enter the names. Like I'm entering Raman, father name Aman, next Akash, Rajesh, Pawan, Mohan, Dilbar, Mahinder, Ashneet, Raman. Suppose I have entered 5-6 names. Bhanu, Naveen, and Ravinder. Suppose I have put these names. Afterward, I am giving the marks. Suppose I am entering 56, 68, 69, 87, 58, 49, and last marks are 86. In chemistry, marks are 78, 45, 65, 58. These marks I have entered for chemistry. Now English marks I am entering. Suppose I have entered these marks. Math marks I have entered now. Bio marks are left. After filling these marks, now I will calculate the total marks. I will calculate by using formula. How to implement the formula? That one question is here. What is the difference between formula and function? If I am writing equal to, formula always will start with equal to. I have to calculate the total of physics, chemistry, bio, English and math marks. I can write column name is C. What is column name? C3. I will write equal to C3 plus D3, then plus E3, then plus F3, then plus and then G3. And after that, after writing all columns name, I will press enter. Result came now. It is the structure of formula. I have put it the formula one by one. I can do the same by using function also. Function I will write now equal to function name is sum and function value will start from first column to last column. I will select all the columns. Afterward, what I will do? I will close the bracket. I will press enter. Now same result will come. So we can use also function and we can also use formulas. The difference between function and formula is that function should have proper name, function should have structure, function should have opening range and closing range, but formula can be as per the user requirement. Now I need not to write formula for everything. I'll select this part, I'll drag and drop the same and it will implement on full sheet. Good idea it is. Now next is percentage. Percentage can be calculated. It is fully depend upon total marks. And total marks are column name is H3. So I'll write here equal to H3 divide by how many subjects? I said 500 multiply by 100. Now see the result. The result is 76.4. Now I'll do the same. I'll drag and drop. It will go to last line. Next is position. Position can be calculated like I'll write here if equal to if percentage less than 70 percentage column name is I3 column last name is I8. I'll write by other method if I3 less than 70. If condition is true, then position is second. Otherwise, position is first. And after that, I'll press enter. See now, it's the first position. I'll apply the same thing, drag and drop. It will apply for full sheet. This is the result analysis of any grade. Now how I can design in better way? I can insert the row on the above. I'll click on top corner. I'll press insert. New row can be insert very easily. Same thing, new column I want to insert. I can insert column in between also, like I'm clicking here insert. It will also inserting. I can delete also. Now I'm giving the heading. What I'll do, I'll select the all columns, click on merge and center. I am giving heading here Montfort World School. In next line I am writing heading here result analysis. Now if I want to find how many got more than 70% marks or more than more than 60% marks. So we have one conditional formatting there. I'll click on conditional formatting. I'll select here top bottom rules. I'll select top bottom rules and I'll click on more rules now. Conditional formatting. Highlight cell rule, in highlight cell rule between, or I can write more than. So I am taking here highlight cell rule greater than. Who are greater than 60% or 65%, that should become red with red text. Firstly, I will select the column. Now I will give the condition for this column. Now greater than and okay. Now see, all are greater than 65%. It will become highlighted. Now I can make it in good way. I'll make the border, and border is in this field, this option, all borders I'll do. Afterward, I'll make it different color combination. Like color, I can fill. This will become red color. This can become, otherwise I can fill with different formatting. Like this will become yellow. This is become other color now. This is become, I can make in good design as per my requirement. So this is the basic structure of MS Excel sheet. In next section, we will discuss about in detail about the formulas of Excel sheet. In this section, we will cover this part only. So wait for next section and see. It will be very fruitful for you, for a practical point of view. Thank you. Thank you. Have a nice day.